Everybody blue ready?
Yep.
Everybody red ready?
Yep.
You're running it? Okay. 3, 2, 1, go!
So.
Go.
I'm going.
Hey,
Right now we're doing some minor repairs during the competition. Our claw caught within one of the goals, and that
need this one.
Yes, we do need that one. And that caused one of our balls to become not counted
two
for
of them.
Points.
Two of them.
But we still won this round, which was nice.
I'm Neil Wenger. I'm a technology coordinator here at the NAIT Manufacturing Center. Well, today we're having a competition, a VEX Robotics Competition. Last year, the Edmonton School Board bought a whole bunch of VEX kits, and they were looking for somebody to host a competition for them. So they came to us and said, can you host a VEX competition for us? We said, yeah, we'd love to do that. So this is our first year trying to do this here in Alberta. So last year I went down to BC and see how they do it there. We brought a couple people from there to help us here. We've had a bunch of different coaches clinics and scrimmages leading up to this for the students. So basically bringing up all of the local high schools up to speed on how to compete in the VEX competition. Well, every year the competition changes the objective and the game. So the field itself, the 12x12 field, stays the same, but the actual game pieces that are inside, as well as you'll notice the gates and fences inside, all that changes from year to year. So each year they come up with a new game, that requires a different robot or a different strategy to win. This year it's called Gateway, because they have the gates that go up and down. They take those game pieces, they get paired up in alliances, a red alliance and a blue alliance, and their job is to get as many of the objects into a scoring position as they can in the time that they have. There's two portions to the match. The first 20 seconds is autonomous, where the robot's supposed to run on its own without a driver control. And then there's a 2-minute period where they have driver control, where they control it, kind of like a remote control car. This is our first year, and we managed to get 18 teams come out this year, which I think is pretty amazing because they're all rookie teams. I think next year we could easily have a whole lot more people because Edmonton Public has quite a few of these. Originally we were hoping to get 6 teams from local schools with 2 teams each. We have teams from Port McMurray, from Lacombe, from Spruce Grove, from Lloydminster, from Fort McMurray have all come to our event this year.